You're listening to the Options Insider Radio Network. For more quality options programs, visit www.theoptionsinsider.com or search for Options Insider Radio Network in your podcast provider of choice. Listeners can also access all of our programming through our mobile app, available in iTunes and on Google Play. Don't forget to follow along with your favorite programs and submit your own questions for the hosts at twitter.com/options, facebook.com/theoptionsinsider, or via questions@theoptionsinsider.com.
Welcome to the Options Playbook, the program where we break down cutting-edge option strategies and explain how you can incorporate them into your own portfolio. Whether you're looking to grow your capital with some offensive maneuvers or protect your investments with defensive plays, you can find them all in the Options Playbook. The Options Playbook is brought to you by Ally Invest. Anything mentioned today is for educational purposes and is not a recommendation or advice. Options involve risk. Please refer to ally.com/invest/disclosures to review additional risks involved with trading options. Securities offered through Ally Invest Securities, LLC, member FINRA and SIPC. Now, let's open the playbook and get started.
Welcome to Options Playbook Radio. I'm your host, Brian Overby, Ally Invest Senior Options Analyst and author of the Options Playbook. All right. Well, we've taken the last couple of sessions to talk to our listeners out there and answer some listener questions. So please do send all your questions in because it makes for a great show when Mark and I can get together and huddle up and talk a little bit about what the listeners are looking for from Options Playbook Radio. And this week, we're going to jump right back into a strategy. So the strategy we're going to look at today is a skip strike butterfly, and it's going to be in Alphabet, or better known as GOOGL. So that's trade that we're going to look at. So if you want to follow along at home and you have the Options Playbook on your table, please turn to page 109 for skip strike butterflies with calls. And as always, if you do not have the Options Playbook, you can always run over to optionsplaybook.com and just look for the strategies tab. And under that tab, you will see skip strike butterflies with calls. And lastly, if you have the Kindle edition, just go to the table of contents and look for the plays. And in that section, you will see a link to the strategy. All right, so today's going to be short and sweet. We've talked about skip strike butterflies before, but not as much so about the opportunity. And as always on Options Playbook Radio, these are not meant to be recommendations. We just talk about them as a paper trade, as a learning experience. My main goal is to talk about times when the conditions are set up to do decent trades. Now, I've looked at skip strike butterflies in high price stocks. I specifically like to do them around earnings. Once again, not meant to be a recommendation, but I like the dynamics of the option pricing on high price stocks around earnings for this strategy specifically. And I know that we've done them a few times, but you know, there's only 15 stocks on a very quick search that are priced somewhere between $200 and $2,000. Now, we're just talking about stocks, not indexes. And I would rather do them in stocks because of the way volatility works in stocks as opposed to indexes. In general, stocks usually have more volatility than an index would. So I look for these opportunities. And what has happened recently in GOOGL is that the news has came out that Europe wants to fine them a few billion dollars. It's like me dropping a dollar on the sidewalk. But bottom line is that's what Europe is upset with GOOGL about the way they do their searches, and they've threatened them. And that has created some volatility in GOOGL overall. And I just think that that's an opportunity. It's not as good as an earnings report, and vol is kind of dropping off a little bit. And it would have been better to look at this trade yesterday after the major news came out. But overall, GOOGL today, and we're taping on 6/28 after the market close. It is a Wednesday. The market is not open. You should be listening to this on a Thursday. GOOGL closed at 961.01. It was up $12.92 today. So that's a very good move after, you know, what was perceived to be a bad news event, and it was. I mean, nobody wants to be fined. So, like, yesterday would have been the perfect time, but guess what? Options Playbook Radio wasn't taping yesterday. So we still have a little bit of increased vol. If I look at the volatility chart on Google, the 52-week low in implied volatility is all the way down on just a 30-day basis is as low as 10%. And the 52-week high, and that would be right around earnings, is 31%, right? That's the 52-week high, and that's even around earnings. So when you're looking at implied volatility, and I'm just rounding off here, we actually had, after the major news event happened, the 30-day implied on Google ran up to 25%. So that's a pretty good spike. So that made me think skip strike butterflies. And now I'm going to explain why, but let's set up the trade, because a lot of people are probably saying skip strike butterflies. What are they? Well, if you go out and you're looking at the strategy, there's some AKAs. Some people will call it a broken wing butterfly. Some people will call it a split strike butterfly. I prefer the term skip strike, because that's what we're actually doing within the butterfly. We're going to skip a strike that we normally would buy, and that embeds a credit spread into the butterfly that helps pay for the butterfly. And that's the whole concept, is that by skipping the strike, we're embedding a credit spread inside this trade. So I have the trade all set up here, using my Ally Invest option chains. And here's where we're at. So let's recap where Alphabet closed today. And I'm going to refer to it as Google going forward. But Google closed at 961.01. Market was up $12.92. We're going to look at the nearest term expiration. We're going to look at the expiration that is June 30th, which is 2 days away. We're going to go out of the money, and we're going to be bullish on our forecast. We're a little worried about Google just gap opening or making a big open. That's where we would get hurt the most. But we're still going to do what we normally do around earnings, look at what the at-the-money straddle is trading for to give us some idea of what the quote-unquote expected move would be before the June 30th expiration. So with the market at 961, I'm looking at the 960 call and the 960 put. And I'm just going to round off here to make things simple. Those two combined, if you bought them both, they'd be trading for about $12.50. Okay. Why is that important? Well, we're going to use that to try to pick where we want our middle strike to be in the skip strike butterfly, which is the most important strike to us. That's where the sweet spot is on any butterfly. And we'd like it to happen as close to expiration as possible. So with the added juice, we can actually go that far out and get this trade done for a net credit to the account. And so here's where we're at. If you take $12 and you add it to 960, that's 972.50. That would be what the marketplace expected. If the market goes up more than that, you're taking the over. If the market goes down or is less than that, doesn't move as much, you're taking the under. Now, the market could go the exact opposite and go straight down. But this is what the over-under, or what the line is, or what the expected move is for Alphabet in the near term. Now, a lot of people look at this more so around earnings. We're just going to look at it because we had the spike up in vol, and we're going to use that. The stock already moved to 12 and a half points today, so we know Google can do that move pretty simply. Okay, so here's the trade. We are going to go out and buy the June 30th expiration 970 call option. We are then going to sell two of the June 30th expiration 975 call options. And for it to be a normal butterfly, we would go and buy that expiration 980 call option. But we're going to skip that expiration, and we're going to buy the 985 call option instead. So this is a normal butterfly in that it is a 1x2x1. But as I mentioned on the top of the show, we skipped the 985 strike, which means we've actually embedded a credit spread from the 980 to the 985 inside our butterfly. What that means to us is that our max risk is now the width of that credit spread, which is 5 points. Now, right now, with the market closed, it's hard to say with the market open, but the market's closed, so I guess the quotes are real time because the market isn't moving. The midpoint of this trade is 17 cents credit to the account. Okay. Now, that might not sound like a lot per se, but remember, our max risk here is 5 points or $500. We're doing this for a 17 cent credit, or $17 gets brought into our account for every 1x2x1 skip strike butterfly we put on. In general, that's about 3.5%. And we're trying to do this over a couple of days. If you look at it as I'm just dead wrong and GOOGL doesn't go up at all over the next couple of days, that's not a bad return on a $500 investment. Now, we always look at a 1x2x1 on Options Playbook Radio. We keep everything in the most simplest terms. But you always got to think about commissions. And a 17-cent credit on a 1x2x1 and commissions can eat up a lot of that. You'd almost want to do a little bit more, but not meant to be a recommendation overall. Just pointing out facts. Okay. Now, when a butterfly is put on, and I don't care if it's a skip strike, if it's a Christmas tree butterfly, there's many different fancy names for butterflies and different ways to set them up. The biggest thing to know is that you have this dilemma in that you want the stock to go to your middle strike, and you've sold two options for each one that you bought, right? Because it's a 1x2x1 ratio of that middle strike option contract. Now, in this instance, that's 975. That's about, well, it's 14 points higher than where the underlying stock is at. So it would be a little bit more than the expected move. Now, if it goes there, the problem is you want your at-the-money option contracts to expire worthless, but now they're at the money. So if you have a lot of time value left in them, those option contracts are where all the juice is at. So butterflies take a long time to max out. And it's best that this move happens closer to expiration because you want to pay as little as possible to buy those two sold option contracts back. Hence, making your gain as big as possible. Get it? All right. That's why we chose this expiration. We had a little bump up in vol that gives us an opportunity. We have the June 30th expiration. So we really have two full trading days until these option contracts will expire. We had implied volatility jump up a little bit. What else removes time premium from at the money option contracts, if you're correct? A decrease in volatility. So I prefer to do this type of trade on the call side because when markets go up, volatilities have a tendency to go down more often than go up. So in this instance, we have two good factors working for us. We had a little bit of a spike based off of news. The vol is still a little bit high. We're going to have a large rate of time decay, and hopefully we're going to get a volatility crunch. Okay. So if that is the case, and Alphabet does go up, and it even gets to our long strike, the 970 strike call, this trade can be profitable even above and beyond the net credit that we received. The maximum that this trade could be is $5. In other words, we could get $5 plus the net credit. Hopefully, if we could fill at a midpoint, which, you know, you're going to have to work this type of order of 17 cents, the maximum upside would be $5.17. And if you make that, well, you should receive the stupid award for it. Why? Because that means that you went to the short strike and you didn't close it out. You didn't close it out. You just said, oh, I hope that GOOGL expires right on my short strike, right? That's the only way. And if it hits your short strike over the next couple of days, get out. Your max risk happens when the stock gets above 980. From 980 to 985, you can lose $5. That $5 that you were looking to make could turn to a $5 loss in a hurry. So your maximum risk here is that GOOGL actually gaps open about 15, 16, 17 points, right? Or even 20 points. That's where your real major concern is. If it slowly goes up, well, that gives you an opportunity to get out of the trade. And if you're dead wrong and the market goes down, well, oh, well, you made your net credit to the account. You can let the options expire worthless. That simple. Okay. So conditions are right. We got a little bit of a pop-up, not quite as good as if it was an earnings report. If it was an earnings report and we went out, the expected move, you know, at least the expected move, you'd probably be looking to make 30, 40, 50 cents as a net credit on this trade because vols would be up that high. But not bad. I'll take the 17 cent net credit, 3.5% on the $500 maximum risk of the trade. And that's it for this episode of Options Playbook Radio. So we'll just take a peek at this trade next week. It is going to be the 4th of July, but we'll be back next week, next Thursday, 1 week away. And we'll look at this trade and introduce a new trade. So thanks for listening. And I want to let you know, if you have a topic you'd like to discuss on the show, or a question you'd like us to answer in the program about any of the strategies, or just in general, you can direct them to me at my email address, theoptionsguy@invest.li.com. That's theoptionsguy@invest.li.com. And as always, thanks for listening. We'll be back at the same time, same place next week. Until then, may all the options you bought finish in the money, and all the ones you sold finish out.
The Options Playbook was brought to you by TradeKing Group. Anything mentioned today is for educational purposes and is not a recommendation or advice. Options involve risk. Please refer to tradeking.com/ODD to review additional risks involved with trading options. Securities offered through TradeKing LLC, member FINRA and SIPC.
The preceding program was a production of the Options Insider Radio Network. For more quality options programs, visit www.theoptionsinsider.com or search for Options Insider Radio Network in your podcast provider of choice. Listeners can also access all of our programming through our mobile app, available in iTunes and on Google Play. Don't forget to follow along with your favorite programs and submit your own questions for the hosts at twitter.com/options, facebook.com/TheOptionsInsider, or via questions@TheOptionsInsider.com.